Tell me, do you see yourself, let's say, as a member of Detroit Techno Dream Team?
No.
Well, I mean, that's a really... I do.
Juan, Jeff Mills.
I do consider
Derek
myself. Man. I do consider myself a, you know, interwoven into this fabric of what it's called. But am I a front runner? I don't know about that. I mean, those guys will always be. In the front, I mean, Derek, Kevin, and Juan. Then there's Jeff, who has his own thing going. Jeff is amazing. Jeff's music is so amazing. Oh my gosh. And to even be compared with him, I don't think it's right, because Jeff actually is from the old school. Jeff got me into dance music, so to speak, in 84, 85. I was listening to him on the radio. He was called The Wizard. And he was playing a lot of old Juan Atkins stuff, Cybertron stuff, along with a whole bunch of other stuff, rap and all that kind of stuff. And he was like a really monumental person in a lot of our lives, from Detroit, the guys from Detroit doing dance music, along with this other DJ called Mojo. And these two guys, Jeff Mills and Mojo, played all this music that we would normally never hear. So yeah. But I have to say, in Detroit's defense, that every big city has that. Every big city has the big the violence and the New York, Chicago, no matter where you go, you're going to have it. Mm-hmm. So you have to draw, there's a yin and yang to it. Mm-hmm. The bad thing about Detroit is that we don't have a lot of yang. Uh-huh. You know, I mean, we have the bad stuff, but we don't have a whole bunch of good stuff that balance it out. In other words, we don't have like a thriving cultural downtown area where you can go and you can entertain and all that. We don't have all that kind of stuff. Detroit is big, but Detroit is big because the neighborhoods are really, really big, which makes Detroit really big.
Tell me why European DJs are not so popular in America. For example, the American DJs are very, very popular in Europe.
Well, that's mainly because the music is big over here. It's not that big in the States. Mm-hmm. I mean, if the music was big in the States, then we would be a lot more, or you guys, the Europeans, would be a lot bigger in the States, but it's not that way. The Americans are really closed-minded when it comes to music. Mm-hmm. I'm talking about corporate people, like the people in the music industry. They don't really, they're like this. If it doesn't have lyrics, they don't want to hear it, basically. And that's actually, there's some crossover bands like Prodigy. They're getting big in the States. They are big in the States. Mm-hmm. Who else? Chemical Brothers. Yeah, I mean, but they have vocals. You can't make it in the States
without words.
Yeah. Yes. So if that was the case, then yeah, it would be a lot better. But.
Okay, let's back to your music. I heard that some people call your music something as techno soul. Mm-hmm. Did you heard that?
I've heard something to that effect.
Do you like it? This term,
techno soul.
I don't think it's meant to be disparaging. I think it's, if they call my music soulful or whatever, hey, that's, if it's called, if they call it techno funk, I don't care what it's called, as long as it's not bad. I mean, you know what I mean? I mean, I come from city of music, Motown. I mean, and I grew up with a lot of soulful influences. So, hey, that's a compliment, you know.
Kenny, how would you describe your music style and what are your influences?
My influences. Yes. My influences are those two DJs I talked about. Musically though, they're I don't know, Kraftwerk. I have a lot of jazz influences. A lot of funk and Parliament, George Clinton, and all those guys. Yellow. Yeah, a lot of influences. I mean, that's the one thing about it is that we can take a mixture of those influences and you can put it up in a pot and you can stir it around and you make whatever you make out of it. And everybody's different in that. And that's why I think a lot of the Detroit music is a little bit more respected than the other stuff is because we have strong influences. And I'm sorry, what was your first question?
How would you describe your own music?
I don't know. That's the hardest thing for an artist to do, I think, is to describe their own music. It's whatever you want it to be. My goal in when doing music is to try to like get across this feeling that I did when I recorded the track. If I can get that feeling across to you when you listen to the track, it's good.
Is it the final target of your music club?
No, by far no. Actually, the more mellow tracks are the ones that people like more than the clubbier tracks. So I mean, I don't go into the studio and go, okay, I'm gonna make a club track. That's not how it works. I can go to the studio and not be inspired to do anything for weeks, mm-hmm. and just sometimes, just out of the blue, you can sit there and then 2 hours later you can have the song, and you know what I mean. But I played live in Tokyo a couple of years ago, and one of the tracks that the people went absolutely crazy over was a metal track. It was called Tedra. It's off the first album. Yeah. And you know, that's the more that's the more melodic stuff, mm-hmm. that the people relate to. Three favorite. Derek is definitely one. Derek is a human being, and mm-hmm. sometimes he has okay nights, mm-hmm. but to see him in tip top form is amazing. Mm-hmm. Derek, he would make you cry if you saw him in tip top form.
Okay, second.
Jeff is really good. Technique, well, I mean, to see Jeff is like to see a show. You know what I mean?
Okay, and the third must be from Europe.
From Europe? Is there anybody from Europe that I really. Oh, Laurent is really good. Laurent Gagné. Yeah. He's really good. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, I mean, those, just quickly, I mean, without me really thinking about it, those are the three that kind of.
Okay, and to finish this interview for our kids in Croatia who wants to be a DJ, one very simple question, how to be a DJ, your advice?
Buy two turntables, buy some good music, buy a variety of music. Don't just listen to one style of music, no matter what it is, Detroit style or Europe, it doesn't matter. Just buy different styles of music and practice.
And be yourself.
Practice, be yourself, practice. It took me, I was doing it since 87, and I've been touring extensively for, I don't know, 5 years now, so it takes a long time to get really good, so.
Okay, Kenny, thank you very much for being here.